Well, good afternoon, boys and girls. Welcome to my social studies class. My name is Mr. Goudreau. And what I have here, folks, is an apple. Good looking shiny apple. But this is no ordinary apple. You see, this apple is very special. Yes, indeed, it is an apple just like this entire box of apples. But this apple is unique. This apple is an individual. Indeed, that is what the objective of today's lesson is. Individuality. You people, like these apples, are all different in some ways, yet all the same. And it is these differences, though, that make us all special. Now, you see this apple? Just by looking at it, I can describe it. It's a little lopsided, a little off balance, but that doesn't mean it's a bad apple. It's a tough apple. It's got some scars here, some slash marks, some bruises, like maybe it was in a fight with another apple. See, it's got some green, it's got some red, good healthy mixture of green and red. Yes, young man.
Teacher, maybe it's got H1N.
That's very possible. Maybe this apple should go home. It's got a very big stem, and also, this apple, you can tell just by looking at it that it's different than maybe other apples. But also, I have a name for this apple. This apple's name is Chester. And Chester, it's a very interesting apple. See, Chester's just gone through a tough relationship, and Chester is new on the single scene, and he's finally met a new girl, and Chester went on a date last weekend with like sweet little Granny Smith, and Chester had a really good time. Now, we're all going to do an activity. As you can see, I brought enough apples for everybody. And what you're going to do is come up and get an apple. Actually, I'll just pass around this box and you can take an apple. And what I want you to do is really get to know your apple. Take a good look at your apple, and I want you to describe the person next to you, your apple. I want you to come up with a name for your apple and make a quick little story about your apple, just like I did. Oh, you forgot Edwin. And what I want you to do is talk to the person beside you. Tell them about your apple. Tell them your little story. To introduce your apple, describe some of the features to the person beside you. And take a minute and do that. And in a second, I'm going to ask someone to share their apple's story. Okay, grade fours, is there anyone who'd like to share the story of their apple? Thank you for volunteering, Will. Introduce your apple to the class.
Well, it's actually an alien apple. Oh. I wouldn't want to pronounce the name because I'd get it wrong.
Ah, but, very neat.
You know, it travels through time.
Ah. Is there any key descriptions you'd like to share with the classroom about your apple?
I don't want to hurt its feelings.
Understandable. Very sensitive. You have a very interesting looking apple. Would you care to share the class?
Sure. I named my apple Leaf because it's got a leaf. And it was the first one to discover North America.
An incredible apple. Yes, Jackie.
My apple's name is Brunita, and when she was 5, she fell down and had to get stitches and go to the hospital.
Most unfortunate, but survived. Here she is. Jackie, please share. Do you care?
She's Jackie. I'm not.
I mean, Kayla.
My apple's name is Don, and he's from Nova Scotia because he's a Mac.
East Coast.
Yes.
Excellent. Okay, now class. Very good, very good. Now I'd like to try a little experiment to see just how well you've done to know your apples. Put your apples back in the box.
Oh, I know it.
Bye.
You got the leaf.
Take the leaf now.
Kayla.
Thank you.
Now. I want to invite volunteers to come up and see if they could find their apple. Burgerman? Who really thinks that they can that Burgerman will find his apple?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
No.
I do.
I do.
I mean, they're all apples. How could he possibly find one that is his?
That's mine.
yeah. What's your
Jimmy?
Jimmy, you found it. How did you find Jimmy?
Because Jimmy's got the little scrapes.
No.
Very interesting. Okay, you can go. You and Jimmy can go sit back down. okay, very good. Now, would anyone care to share with the class how apples are like people? Can anyone make that connection? Well, the connection is...
Nope, apples aren't like people.
You heard Jimmy.
poor Jimmy. Yes, what happened?
Yeah, the apple, as you described it, the people, sometimes you can see somebody from outside, you cannot just decide if it is a good apple or a bad apple, so you have to dig inside and find out. So the apple is the same thing. You cannot say that apple is sweet or sour until you taste it. So the person, as a human being, you can check, you cannot just decide if the person, you know, how he looks or how he dresses.
Very good, Mohammed. Thank you.
Teacher, yes? I've got to add this, but I've heard Aboriginal people who get mad. Haven't you heard this saying? They get mad at some of their Aboriginal relatives if they want to become like a white person, and they'll say, you're red on the outside, but white on the inside. Haven't you heard that?
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Yes.
Sorry, that was awful.
Inappropriate, young man. Okay, good. Yes. And I hope the connections that you're all making is that the apples are like people. Same, yet different. It's the differences that make us all special. Now, quickly to summarize, I'd like you guys to... Oh, that was a bad side. You'll pull a burger in here and... how are people different? And what? Anyone tell me. How are people different? Yes, Kayla.
They all look different.
They all look different.
Are you saying different than apples, or...?
No. How are people different from each other?
Ah.
But how are people the same? Yes, Reese.
We have kidneys.
We have kidneys.
We have the same blood. We have the same blood.
We have the same blood. I'll just check that.
We're all mammals.
We're all mammals, yes.
But someone was born from an egg.
Yes.
We have different values.
We do have different values. Thank you. Very important. Helps to shape our identity. Yes.
People have different languages and cultures.
Very important. Yes. Languages. Culture. Now, I want you guys to know that. Yes, we described a lot about the outside of the apples, but remember, before you leave here, that, like Chester here. Chester has a little star inside of him. And that's what makes him special. And just each and every one of you have a little star inside of you. So when you leave here today, just remember that. And then, next class, I want you to come in with a story written about your apple. One page, double spaced. Where's 100% your final mark? And that's my lesson.